check. We're back. So, natagalan ang aking next vlog because
we actually enrolled him in an obedience
school. Nangarte-arte naman itong babae. So, pa-school-school pa sa ato. Ano ba? Personal experience with their breed.
Mom!
Hi guys! Welcome again to another vlog. It's me, Mommy Nee. Welcome! I know. Parang medyo natagalan yung last vlog ko. Siguro last vlog was December. Maraming nangyari these past few months. Na nasira yung lights ko. So, yung mga pag-shoot inside. Pangalawa, nagkaroon ako ng maraming projects. So, maraming musbong opportunities. I'm very grateful for that. And lastly, ako ay I give birth to this animal. With this boy. Marami akong gustong i-share sa inyo, especially when it comes to parenting and the things that I've learned nung ako na mismo yung talagang nakapag-alaga ng new pup. If you want to know more tips and guides and things that I've learned, if you want to learn, please keep on watching. This is me. Mag-vlog tayo, anak. Okay, first and foremost, I'd like to welcome the new member of the family. Hi, his name is Theodore! Tia! It's a Chow Chow. So basically, in this video, I will be sharing with you 10 things that you need to know before getting a Chow Chow. So kung nag-research ka na, medyo hindi na ako masyadong mag-explain kung saan sila nanggaling, ganyan, yung things that you can already search in Google. So more of my personal experience talaga with their breed. Let's get started. Number one, you need a job before getting this breed. It's not easy. If you want him or her to have a longer life, you really have to have a certain budget for your chows, okay? So yun, that's number one lang. That's something to consider. Kung medyo tight budget ka na, medyo mag-iisip na ako agad. Number one alam. Ayun, aside from that pa, parang basically talaga in getting a dog in general, hindi siya talaga mura. So ito parang medyo mas extra lang talaga. And I will explain to you why. Okay, number two. Surprise. Chow-chows nowadays in the Philippines, ngayong year 2021, a good quality chow will range from 35,000 even to 80K to 100K. So, kasi meron there such thing as yung mga champion line, yung mga ganyan, yung pinang-showdog. Talaga, meron naman talaga yung binibreed talaga nila kasi maganda talaga yung lahi ng kanilang chow. Number three, trainability. Mostly, it depends on the breed. There are breeds na talagang can be easily trained. And feeling ko lahat naman pwedeng matrain basta you really be consistent and you start them very young. So I'll show something here. This is a video of my husband training Theo the night or the next night that we got him. So yan, he was 3 months old back then. So yan. So we started training him ng ganyan. Tapos that is really everyday repetition. And until now, he's already 7 months old. We actually enrolled him in an obedience school, parang training puppy 101, ganyan. Because we really want to what's best for him, and you know, we want it to be guided properly. So that's really one thing why we actually enroll him. And the reason why, kasi maraming tao parang ano ba yan, nakaarte-arte naman itong babae, pa school-school pa sa aso. Ano, parang, okay, I'd rather spend it on his food or ano. What the hell? Okay, wait lang. May reason naman kung bakit gusto ko naman ginagawa itong mga bagay na to, di ba? Hindi naman nalang gusto ko lang. Okay, so, first and foremost, if hindi mo ako kilala personally, I am 4'9 to 5 feet tall. And getting a huge breed, a medium-sized dog. Imaginin mo naman, kinakaladkad ako nitong kalaking aso na to. Ano yun? Yun yung inisip ko. Parang feeling ko, getting a bigger breed or a huge dog is really a responsibility. Kaya naman, nabili-bili ako ng chow-chow, tapos hindi ko siya ma-handle, di ba? Parang ano ba naman yan? Hinihilan niya ako. Otherwise, it depends. I have to ask. Kasi I feel sad when people say that you cannot train them. They're very lazy, ganyan. I'm very defensive of this because, no, you can actually train chow chows. So there. The trainability, it still depends on you. Four. Sustainability. Most of the time, lahat ng babanggitin ko dito, medyo related to number one. So, sustainability requires na naman money. Okay, just so you know, chow chows need a lot of supplements. Ano ba itong mga supplements na ito? You have, number one, you have to really take care of their fur and coat. So, you have vitamins for that. You even have to give them calcium. Actually, I'll share to you this. I got Theo 3 months and he was this small. Okay, I thought he was cute. He was so parang I can take care of it because it's smaller, it's compact daw, mas maliit. Alam mo yun. Pero little did I know, when I started talking to experts about his breed, dun ko lang na-realize that his ears being down, that actually means that he lacks calcium. Internal issues when they grow old, so you really have to have another supplement for that. Maybe I will share those things on my next vlog. So yun. Number 5, time requirement. Of course, number 1, as I said, you really need to train them. Given naman yun sa lahat ng a happy dog is somebody who is physically and mentally challenged. Kailangan meron ka talagang dedicated hours of the day to groom your chow chow. They shed a lot. So, ayun. Just to share with you, Theo pa lang, I have 3 brushes already. Mga 10 minutes. Tapos dito, mga 10 minutes. Tapos dito, mga 10 minutes. So, parang that's 30 minutes of your day. Aside from the training part, very important talaga yung time kasi you need to groom them. Number 6, they shed a lot. And when I say a lot, I could not even stress how a lot means. Hindi lang ganito. As in, a lot means, usually per session, you can create another dog. As in, kahit lalaki siya, nakanganak siya ng another chow chow. Okay, si Theo kasi parang nasa shedding season pa siya. So, hindi siya masyadong fluffy right now. He's just 7 months old. So, parang talaga nagde-develop pa yung fur and coat niya. Number 7, adaptability. So, chow chows are not for everyone. If you're looking for a breed or if you're looking for a dog in general who will come to you whenever you want, you won't get that from chow chows. In general, chow chows are very independent. They're strong-willed and as much as I don't want to say this, but they're stubborn. Socializing them with people and other dogs at a very young age would really help. Next. Okay, common health issues. So, number 1 issue are hot spots. Ito yung mga bald areas na biglang nakakalbo yung dog mo. Most of them, usually, pag hindi mo na-treat, nag-escalate, tapos nagiging mange, tapos nakakalbo yung chow-chow, your maintenance, and how do you keep your dog clean, and at the same time, yung sa mga parasites ba, kung talagang natututukan mo siya dun sa area na yun. Because by now, if you don't know, chow-chows have thick hair, so they're very susceptible to parasites, to ticks, to lice, ganyan. So, it's harder to really get rid of it. So, like me, meron talagang maintenance si Theo sa kanyang fur. Yun. So, I use 2 products. That's Bravecto or NexGard Spec. Okay, number 9. Their diet. Okay, I'm trying to discuss this here in this vlog because if you're not very specific about their diet, most of the time, magkakaroon ng complications yung chow chow mo as they grow older. Don't get me wrong, ha? It's always best to consult vets, pero in my experience, it's also best to look for somebody who specializes in that kind of breed. Mas talaga maalagaan yung aso mo. And I'm very thankful that I found groups and I found mentors that really guided me on how to take care of people. Number 10. Last but not the least, last thing you need to know about a chow is that they're very loyal. Usually pick at least one or two members of your family and they will be very obedient and loyal to them. He's a very good boy in terms of dealing with my child, because if you buy them as puppies, tendency is they really get to adapt to whatever situation they have. So, I'd like to end this vlog by saying that no matter how challenging yung mga top 10 na sinishare ko sa inyo, I could not imagine my life without my child anymore. Without my dog anymore. I hope you get to learn something from me today, and maybe next time I'll share more tips on how to really take care of this little boy. Or he's not a little boy, but of this breed. Siguro it really took me around 3 months to get this habit na parang hindi siya challenging. Parang routine na talaga siya sa aming mag-asawa or this family. So that's why it really took time for me before I share something valuable to you guys. So, ayun. So, thank you again for watching. I'll see you again on my next vlog. Bye!